Hey guys, in case you guys don't know me, I wanted to introduce myself. My name is Sabrina Schoenborn, and for my independent research project, I started a nonprofit organization called Project GIRL, which stands for Groundbreaking, Inspiring, Radiant Ladies. So, what is Project GIRL? Also, I want to thank Rena Bradley for creating this amazing logo. She's absolutely talented and amazing, and I love her so much. You're fantastic. So what is Project GIRL? Project GIRL, I think it's easier to talk about why I started this nonprofit organization rather than what it is. Because this nonprofit organization was created to address a very specific problem that I have grown up seeing, and having younger sisters, I see them dealing with this almost every day. So why did I start Project GIRL? I started Project GIRL because I noticed there was a really distinct difference between how men and women are portrayed in the media. And the way that I want to present this extreme difference of portrayal is by a little thing called the Google experiment, which I started. And I really encourage you to do this small experiment once you leave, because the results are gonna be pretty stark. So what I did was I went to Google and I just searched girls and I looked at the images. And then I deleted that, and I went and I looked into boys. I just typed in boys, and I compared the images. So what did I get when I Google searched imaged girls? This is what I got. As you can see automatically, all of these images, or about 90% of them, are extremely sexualized. In fact, I had to blur out this one at the bottom because it was considered pornographic material, and I didn't feel comfortable showing that. So, how do the boys do? The images are extremely stark, and the most sexual image that you will see on the screen is actually of a woman at the bottom. It is because of this distinct difference between how men and women are portrayed in the media that I started Project GIRL. So, that's the difference. When you Google image search girl, you see pictures of girls in lingerie versus just a normal guy. As I said before, it's this distinct difference that I wanted to start Project GIRL. So now that you all know why I started this, we can go into what it is. So, what is Project GIRL? Project GIRL is a nonprofit organization designed to tell the stories of young women to inspire girls all around the world to be limitless. But that's a lot, so I'm going to break that down for you. One of the main aspects of my nonprofit organization is that I'm going to tell the stories of young girls, but that's a big test, so how am I going to do that? My plan is to interview young women across the world who are considered extraordinary, who are starting community nonprofit organizations, who are doing extraordinary things, writing, STEM projects, anything. Extraordinary girls, I want to interview and showcase them. These are just a couple of the extraordinary women that I've already worked with or have interviewed. All of these articles are going to be posted to our website that is currently up called Project GIRL, and I really encourage you guys to look at it after this. It took a lot of work, and a lot of your own peers helped work with it. Amanda Lucas, Zora Carroll, Rena Bradley, those are just some of the extraordinary women who helped me create this nonprofit organization. So this is where we are going to be putting all of our articles. The process. So I wanted to talk to you today about the process that I go through when I'm writing these articles. So the very first thing I do before I do anything else is I find an extraordinary girl to interview. But that's kind of hard because, as I said before, not a lot of positive young female role models are portrayed in the media, so this has become one of my hardest tasks, to find girls in and of themselves that are extraordinary and are doing extraordinary projects. So to overcome this obstacle, I've been working with different nonprofit organizations to try and connect to those girls. For example, this is the logo from a nonprofit organization called The Girl and I. It is based in the greater Chicago area, and it's an after-school program for girls ages 5 to 13, and I've interviewed 5 girls from this nonprofit. Moving on to the next step, interview. This is Annabelle Barnett. Many of you know her. She is an award-winning equestrian, and she is truly extraordinary. This is just a quick snapshot of my interview with her. I try and interview my girls face-to-face, and what I address in actually the blog that I write for my independent seminar is the beauty of tangents. When I'm interviewing someone face-to-face, I see a lot of tangents go off. I see them go off in these tangents, and that's typically where I find the best material for my articles. Next, and maybe the most hardest, I transcribe these interviews. With the help of the extraordinary Amanda Lucas, we transcribe these 45-minute articles, these 45-minute interviews into articles, or into just text. And this process can take between 6 hours. I once worked on a transcribing an interview just for 6 hours straight, and I had to get it done. And sometimes it can take up to a week if we're spreading it out. The final aspect of this process is to write the physical article. This is a quick screenshot from the Project Girl website of one of my favorite interviews that I've had is Mahika Chopra, who is an 8-year-old girl who is learning to how to be a gaffer through the nonprofit organization that I mentioned earlier, The Girl and I. So where are our girls? I said earlier that I'm interviewing girls all around the world, but where exactly are they? We've currently interviewed girls from about 29 different countries, ranging all the way from Indonesia to New Zealand, to Australia, to the top of Brazil, all the way to the United States. So we've got 29 countries so far and over 40 interviews, which is pretty extraordinary for just starting this a couple months ago. Analytics. So I kind of wanted to share with you our first week analytics. We launched May 2nd, our Project Girl website, which is projectgirl.net, launched May 2nd. So this is basically a week's worth of analytics. In total, we had 1,217 visits in our first couple days, which is pretty extraordinary for a nonprofit organization that just launched. We've been able to reach these high numbers due to our connections with other nonprofit organizations that I'm going to be talking about later. On average per day, we get about 50 to 350 visits or people visiting our website or page views. And in total, we have about $275 in donations, which is, again, can seem really small, but based on the fact that we just started this and we just launched this a couple days ago, I'm really proud of it. What I'm going to be talking about a little bit later is our social media followers. On Instagram, we have 217 social media followers. We have 9 major sponsors, and I'm going to be talking about them later. And we have 45 countries in which who have read our site or visited our site. Current connections. As I was talking about, we have 9 major companies or nonprofit organizations that we are currently working with. These are just a couple of them that you may know. We are working with The Girl and I, which I've talked about multiple times before, Girls Who Code, which is an extraordinary international organization, Girl Rising, Sunrise Movement, Malala Fund, Girl Scouts, and Girls Who Run. We are interviewing a lot of girls from these organizations, and also I've been in contact with the CEOs of these organizations to try to connect our organizations. Social media. What I'm going to be talking about right now is kind of connecting back to my primary and secondary audience. My primary audience for Project Girl is, of course, this generation. It's the girls ranging about ages 10 to 26. That's our primary audience, and we're connecting with them through Instagram. Please go follow us. We're also connecting with my secondary generation, which is the parents and or guardians of these young girls, and we're using Facebook to connect to them. And we're also using email and other messaging sites for our for people who visit the site to come contact us. So what are our next steps in this big kind of scary thing? Continue to post articles to Project Girl. With the help of a lot of women in this room, I've been able to continue to post articles to Project Girl, and I'm going to continue doing that. I'm also going to begin our marketing strategy, which is where we continue to do fundraisers and different projects and events with organizations to get our name out there. I'm going to connect with more organizations, as I said before. We're with 9 major organizations and major companies, and I'm really looking forward to continuing to grow that number. And I want to discover more extraordinary young women. I have been finding that there is a plethora of them, and I'm really looking forward to finding more. And speaking of looking for extraordinary women, I wanted to extend this invitation to all of the females in this room. Project Girl is looking for writers, editors, photographers, anyone who believes they can contribute to this organization. I want this to be based off of the females at Westtown, because honestly, it's the females at Westtown who have inspired me to do this nonprofit organization. So if you are interested in this, please come talk to me or email me after this. So this is just some closing thoughts. As I've been going through this process, I've been hearing a lot of flashback from different organizations that I've reached out to, like, don't you seem too young for this? Don't you seem a little bit immature for this? And if you take anything out of this presentation, I want you to know that you are too young to do something until you are too old to do it. You are never too young to do something, and you are never too old to do it, because those are restrictions that you have just put upon yourself. Last but not least, I wanted to thank so many extraordinary people who have helped this. Teacher Margaret, who has truly helped this organization take off. Teacher Will Addis, who is my advisor, who has helped me from the beginning. Our main graphic designer, Rena Bradley, our main transcriber, Amanda Lucas, and our main web designer, which is Zora Carroll. And if you have any questions, please come talk to me after. Thank you.